Okay, getting ready obviously for the SEC tournament. You clinched the double bye. How important has this kind of extra time been for you and the team to focus on yourselves?
Yeah, I think, you know, obviously the double bye is a big deal. If your goal is to go over and play and win on Sunday, then not having to play earlier in the week matters. It's a big deal. So proud of that. And we do. We get to spend a little bit more time on us this week, get a little bit more rest time leading into the tournament as well, and I think both are good for us right now.
How important do you feel like the SEC tournament will be for seeding when it comes to the NCAA tournament?
I think a good showing will be important for us. Playing well, obviously, winning matters, and I think we've put together a pretty good resume. We finished strong, and we want to continue to do that in the SEC tournament for seeding purposes.
Coach, what have you been seeing out of the girls in practice since you guys beat Kentucky that makes you feel confident going into the tournament?
We were able to review some things, really to go back into I tell them, blast them from the past, go back and do some things that we haven't done in a month or so. To review some things just to make sure we're good. We also really worked on time and score situations heading into the tournament just to make sure that we're thinking, that we're processing, because in those moments you've got to be ready to react.
Coach, in that first game you're going to play a team you've beaten before. How do you make sure your team isn't going to overlook them and have the right mentality in that game?
Yeah, I think that's, it's human nature. You want to make sure that you're combating that. You want to make sure your team is focused. One thing that we have done all year, we keep things very consistent with our preparation, and regardless of the team, does not matter. And I think that helps. The consistency helps, but also they just have to be a mature team and understand you do not advance. You do not get that opportunity if you don't take care of business on Friday.
Coach, yesterday in Horston, you actually get that first team SEC selection. Just probably how you pictured it coming into this year. How proud are you?
Yeah, I'm really excited for both Jordan and Rickea. I think they're both well-deserving of first-team all-conference. They've been pretty consistent all year long. They're dynamic players, and, it's really fun to see them get rewarded for that.
Coach, obviously, this team has a lot of leaders, but is there anyone who's really stepped up that maybe isn't always in that leader limelight, like Jordan Horston or like Rickea Jackson, who are always leading the team, but someone maybe who's really stepped up in the recent weeks as a leader?
I think Jordan Walker has been our consistent leader. She's not the loudest person, but she is the player that you know she's going to be consistent. You know that she's going to compete, she's going to do things the right way, and a lot of times she's a lead by example player, and that's okay too. But she's definitely mature and someone that our team really looks to.
What's the focus these next couple of days? Obviously you're going to be awaiting your opponent, so how do you stay productive in these next couple of days?
Yeah, that's good. We're going to do some team building, some team bonding opportunity, just to try to make sure we're all in it, pulling for each other. We're going to get a couple shoot around and a practice in, and the practice we'll get some more review, work on some offensive efficiency, and then we'll have another shoot around before the game on Friday, which will be very specific to our opponent, because at that point we'll know. So it will be a lot of work on us until Friday.
Is this team's progression from the start of the season to now, is it where you would have expected going into the SEC tournament? Is it above, below, or is it right where you want to be?
Coaches are never satisfied. We are never happy with anything, right? We always want more. For me to not say I wish it was better, I wish it was more, probably not be truthful. But I am really proud of the growth, and I am proud of the journey that we've had and where we are right now. Really am, and I think we're in a good place to compete. You got to go and do it. You got to execute it. But I think the players, they continue to practice well. Physically, they're in a great space. I think they've come out of this season really in a healthy but strong and refreshed space. Because at the end of the year, there are a lot of teams, a lot of players that are dead leg. They're just tired. And I think our team has really pulled through that pretty well.
In January, you mentioned that this program needs to be a Final Four team. Now that we're here in March, what do you need to see in the SEC tournament to kind of give you that confidence that you are that caliber team?
Yeah, I think for us it's minimizing mistakes. It is, you know, having a little bit sharper focus throughout the game for 40 minutes. I think we've proven that we can play with anyone, but we've got to be able to extend our focus and limit mistakes, and that's mistakes on both ends of the court.
Can you kind of build on some of the team building activities that y'all are doing this week and why you think that's important?
Yeah, I think it's important. I think it's just a reminder of we're in this together. We wanted today to be an off day in terms of being on the court, but we wanted to get something out of the day. So we're going to spend some time together tonight once we get there, have dinner together, and you know, just try to enjoy the moment. You know, as a former athlete, I remember a lot of the games, but probably as much as the games, I remember my teammates. Sorry. Yeah, Jordan Walker is, she's just a competitive, tough, gritty player who is, kind of plays with a chip on her shoulder, you know, and she's very consistent, so you know what you're going to get from her. But, you know, going down the stretch, this is her last bit of basketball. You know, she's a super, super senior, I think, at this point. But, you know, she's really motivated, and she wants to end on a high note.
Coach, in every loss except one, you've had higher turnover numbers than assists. And then at Kentucky, you had 26 assists. I think it was 36 made baskets. How do you make that an every night thing?
Yeah, I think that's one of the things that we've had a lot of growth through. When we are high assist, we play really well. Now, that might sound obvious to a lot of people, but some teams play differently. When we're sharing the ball and we're getting a lot of production from everyone, our team is just better. And obviously taking care of the basketball when we're low turnover, I think that's when we're being aggressive as well. Our team understands that's how we need to play, and we've got to continue to find ways to do that.
There's been a lot of obviously criticism of the team, especially earlier in the season. How do you keep that outside of your walls and keep this team motivated and focus on itself?
Yeah, you know, I think that's something that you expect. If you're an athlete, you're in sports, you're going to have that. And you've got to be able to have thick skin and move forward. And we just kept talking to our team about what they believed. And they hung in there. I thought they did a really good job. They came back to practices. They came back believing. And I think sometimes criticism is hard to hear. But when you really and truly have a belief in something, when it's deep in your heart, it's a whole lot easier to get through those moments.
What are some of the words of wisdom that you tell the team when you go into things like the SEC tournament as a coach? Just what are you telling them before you send them out to the court?
Well, they need to have fun. We're a tournament sport. They've got to be focused and leave it out there. You do not want to finish a game and have regrets. That's the last thing you want to do. And so for them, just leave it all out there, have fun, enjoy the moment, and you know, play free. Play free. I think that's going to be important.
I think a good confidence builder for this team too is that even in these ranked opponents, you've had the lead, you've been close, but maybe it comes down to that fourth quarter. Has that been a focus in this team? How do you kind of build upon that?
Well, I think, again, going back to those losses against the tough opponents, we've been very competitive in those games, and you could probably go down four or five possessions made the difference in those games. So we talk about that. That's four or five possessions that we've got to clean up, and that's where we talk about our mistakes, just taking care of that, and whether it's down the stretch, third quarter, second quarter, doesn't matter. You've got to be a little bit better, a little bit sharper in those moments to get those big time wins.
Now that you can look back at the regular season that it's over, do you think that ranked schedule made your team better, and how do you think that growth is going to help you down the stretch?
Yeah, I do. I think it made us better. You know, I think looking at it, I might have overdone it a little bit, but I do think it made us a stronger team. You know, I think we'll still evaluate the finish of the season and see, you know, kind of where we go from here and how it all plays out. But, you know, like where we're at now, we just gotta keep pushing.
How has the development of Darby and Strickland really elevated this team?
Yeah, obviously Tess Darby has been able to shoot from the moment she got here, but now her She's enhanced her game defensively and on the boards, and she's able to be on the court longer, which is good for our offense. Her production has been great. I think it opens up some opportunities for her teammates. And then Caroline Striplin and her work ethic since the moment she got here. I'm just so happy for her to be able to see her come out and produce like she's producing. She can score inside, she can give us a presence inside, but obviously now being able to stretch the defense behind the three-point line is going to open up a lot of things for our team.
What do you think the biggest lesson this team learned during the regular season that they can carry on as you guys go through the postseason?
Oh, how do you narrow it to one?
You can get more than
yeah,
one.
You know, I think one of the biggest things is we learned how we need to play. I think we learned how each teammate needs to play, what our team needs to do to be successful, and really buying into those things, I think, was probably the biggest lesson.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.